100 years ago, the country began moving full steam ahead into what would be known industrially as the modern era. Machines of one kind or another were beginning to dominate where human hands had been the only driving force only a few years before. Just about the only activity center not caught in the mechanized maelstrom of the times was the American business office. In the 1870s, the office was dominated, as it had been for decades before that, by man and by manual methods. About this time, a remarkable invention came along to invade the serenity of the office. It was the revolutionary typewriter. Oh, sorry, sir, you're quite right. The operator was known as the typewriter, and the invention was the incredible typing machine. As typing machines caught on and proliferated in the more progressive offices over the next few years, much of the paperwork that used to be painstakingly written by hand was now painstakingly typewritten by hand. It was a revolution of sorts, at least in the look of the paperwork and the relative ease with which it could be turned out by typewriters instead of penmen. But beyond that, the revolution had little effect. All the basic office chores continued to be performed by hand. But modernization of the office certainly didn't stop there. During the next few decades, the environment changed perceptibly as more and more women learned office skills and were attracted out of the factories into the more genteel atmosphere of the office. Inventions proliferated to make office functions more efficient. In many ways, the office began to look almost as though it had finally wandered into the mechanized age. There were changes in the machinery. And even more so, there were changes in the scenery as the 20th century came of age. But surprisingly, all the basic office functions continued to be performed by hand. By the middle of the 20s, voice communications and sophisticated modes of travel had made dramatic alterations in the office. People in different cities could talk to one another at will. Executives could gather for meetings in far-flung cities. Business was now climbing toward the pinnacles of bigness which would identify the American entrepreneurial system over the decades ahead. But even so, the support system back of all this burgeoning business activity was still far from automated. And in spite of what was happening in factories and in the world at large, those basic office functions continued to be performed by hand. Then came a genuine phenomenon. The electric typewriter came to market. It was fast. It was power driven. It could do remarkable things. It still called for the hands-on expertise of a skilled typist, however, as did all the other business machines which were adding power to many offices. And beyond the enormously beneficial effect on the look and the volume of paperwork that could be produced electrically, even this degree of mechanization had little effect on total office productivity. All the basic functions that fed work to the machines continue to be performed by hand.
Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Finally came the 50s. And with the 50s came substantial increases in the sophistication of business machines. And into this receptive, expectant atmosphere came the 20th century's most remarkable step forward yet. It was the computer. Gigantic, demanding, unfathomable except to the computer experts. given initially to delicate health and disruptive amounts of downtime, but spectacular nonetheless, as electronic data processing began to change concepts as well as procedures. Applications proliferated even faster than computer companies, as order processing, inventory control, accounts receivable, payroll, and countless other functions moved off the desktops and into the computers. But a funny thing happened on the way to all that automation. Depersonalization became so much the order of the day that management began to lose control. Everything was centralized and pulled away from the individual. Technology actually began to create more problems than it solved. There was automation, but no integration, and no assurance that the people who were supposed to be in charge were, indeed, in charge. By the 70s, there was evidence that technology was beginning to move in a direction that reflected sensitivity to management's concerns. The mini-computer came along to minimize the problems of centralization and mute the fears of depersonalization. Managers were resuming control, and the manager-secretary relationship was rapidly being restored. Although technology was not losing ground, the office was once again becoming an environment of people with automation in a proper support role. New concepts in dispersed data processing and modular hardware were hastening the turnabout and laying a foundation for the office of the future. What had been far out thinking only a short time before was now beginning to look feasible. With innovations in sophisticated voice communication systems, with computers as small and friendly as electric typewriters, but with built-in modularity which would permit extensive expansion and integration, the office of the future was clearly moving out of its science fiction context and into the real world. But still, the emphasis until now has been decidedly on the word future. Today, Datapoint, the leader in dispersed data processing and the champion of total electronic integration, is about to change all that by taking the lead once again and ushering in tomorrow's vision today. The key is integration and automation. 100 years after the typewriter, the office is finally catching up with all the technological sophistication which has been so evident for so long in living space, factory space, and outer space. We're no longer dreaming dreams of the future. We're launching an era of true and total integration. That new era starts not with a promise of future fulfillment, but with products and programs ready to perform today. That new era starts right here, right now. Datapoint Corporation has announced significant product introductions that flesh out the reality of what the business office is to become, and to stake its claim, or in fact to reiterate its claim, and deliver the products that bring the truly integrated electronic office to this infant but much respected marketplace. We're announcing something concrete, the manifestation of a carefully developed product strategy that has been a decade in the making at Datapoint. A product strategy that has resulted in a highly successful company in the intervening years, and a strategy that has placed us at the focal point of meeting technologies. In our vocabulary, as in our philosophy, the key word is integrated. We're dealing not in standalone items here, although that capability exists, but in the far more important realm of total integration, where products work in concert to raise productivity and improve cost efficiency dramatically throughout the office environment. The first of these basic elements is dispersed data processing. This has been Datapoint's principal market, one in which our leadership has been conspicuous and growing throughout this decade. The second is communications management products. We are now strongly entrenched here and have fully integrated voice and data communications management. Third is word processing. Word processing involves the full functional integration of text processing with data processing, a common database, and peripheral resources. Fourth, electronic message system. Here we add the capability of fully controlling the collection, transmission, and distribution of information, either data or text. Fifth, individual computing capabilities that are not dependent upon professional data processing assistance. This is a byproduct of all our other capabilities rather than a product in itself, which provides the manager with data processing and storage capabilities he can use himself. And finally, information storage and retrieval. Here, we're talking about the means of managing and using data, wherever and in whatever quantity it may be stored. Even this thumbnail profile reveals an enormous universe of capabilities, both current and coming, all of which are necessary because we're moving into an entirely new and fundamentally changed business environment. Journals, research houses, universities, trade groups, and governments are conducting studies which show conclusively that decreased productivity among white-collar workers is a critical factor in the increasingly complex economics of the business and industrial world. Over half of the American workforce is in the office. While productivity in United States factories has increased 80% in the past decade, office productivity has increased only 3%. Failure to increase productivity is inflationary. Demographics and educational levels indicate that there will be fewer people opting for traditional office jobs. Already, as many as 60,000 new secretarial jobs per year go unfilled. In 5 years, American business will be lacking more than 250,000 secretaries. Moreover, as the nation's birth rate declines, fewer young people will be entering the workforce. However, over 40% of today's workforce, aged 25 to 34, have some amount of college education. Over the next 15 years, their relative numbers and their educational levels will increase, making them better qualified to use sophisticated office products than the office workforce of today. They will be comfortable with the technology they've grown up with. Our management styles will follow these trends, and we'll provide these workers with better, more sophisticated tools to perform office functions. But studies and statistics aside, there are very apparent and practical reasons for our approach, too. A contemporary office is not an integrated office by any means. Different functions occur in different locations quite separately and independently of one another. Data processing is now an integral part of all businesses, but data processing in most instances is a segregated operation within a company. Word processing is a function in and of itself. Currently, it may be a clerical pool operation or word processing at the typewriter of individual typists. Filing, though done in different offices, is frequently done in an even greater number of different ways. It's not integrated with word processing, doesn't relate to data processing, and frequently creates information retrieval problems. Voice communications management, when it exists at all, may be as antiquated and ineffectual as a switchboard operator manually logging outgoing long-distance calls or ordering additional watts lines whenever there's an apparent saturation of existing circuits. Without the speed and control advantages of an electronic message system, managers cannot be assured that vital information will be received and acted upon by those who need it, when they need it. Individual computing simply isn't a factor in most offices today, and as a result, even the most organized managers rarely have access to all the information they need. It's hard to examine all this evidence without concluding that there is indeed a need for all elements of the truly integrated electronic office. And that brings us to where we are and what we're doing here today. The electronic office now becomes totally integrated with the addition of two new elements being introduced by Datapoint at this time: word processing and electronic message systems. When we introduced ARC in 1977, we moved the practicality of the office of the future into the here and now. Through ARC, we tied the small multifunction computer to a nearly infinite number of other multifunction computers. The result is that each has full access to common information, and each is capable of swapping duties with another at any time. ARC became the first truly modular computer, with the additional benefits that components could be placed where needed. Using these components, a user can assemble a small or large system as needed and not face drastic software changes. About this same time, an even more common means of information exchange, voice, was being largely overlooked by companies who were focusing on the creation of the electronic office. In the mid-70s, the voice communications market resembled the computer market in the mid and late 50s. Managers had a critical need for information that would allow them to maximize their rapidly growing voice facilities and bring down their spiraling telecommunications costs. We were ahead of other companies in providing cost-effective products to the communications management marketplace. We could take our existing equipment, apply the technology we already owned, and come up with immediate, cost-justifiable solutions for managers whose telephone costs were out of control. Within a year after we began developing it, customers were using our first product, the InfoSwitch long-distance control system. Within 2 years, we introduced four more products to help management gain control and win the battle against rising telephone costs. The Station Message Detail Recorder, InfoSwitch Share, the Automatic Call Distributor, the Passive Line Monitor. But by far the most significant introduction was InfoSwitch ARC in 1978. This was the vehicle for integrating all of our earlier systems into the ARC system, thus achieving total integration of voice and data, and further advancing Datapoint toward the electronic office. Market acceptance for InfoSwitch ARC was immediate. ARC users found they could attach any InfoSwitch product to any other InfoSwitch product and attach them all to the data processing ARC system for a degree of control never possible before. Now, for the first time, communications costs could be entered directly into the general ledger, and the telephone directory software package could instantly provide information on the location, phone number, or mailing address of anyone in the organization. The result achieved through integrating InfoSwitch and ARC provided our customers with a combination much greater than the sum of its parts. There are many important elements that make up the integrated electronic office. One is word processing. Users are demanding systems that perform more than conventional data processing. Today, word processing has become a vital capability of computing systems. In essence, any desktop processor must be capable of doing any task. The key is integration. Datapoint's word processing system goes far beyond just simplified editing and modification of documents. It's a system that's designed for easy operation and long-term growth, and useful by clerks as well as managers. The Datapoint word processing system is full-featured with side-scrolling, multi-purpose format control, cut and place, text replacing, and many other features. And perhaps most important to existing customers, it runs on our standard equipment. As an additional feature, and as an example of integration, word processing users, if authorized, can take information such as parts lists created by data processing applications and add that into memos or other documents. The opposite may also be done. The end result is drastic savings in rekeying needed information. We're talking about physical as well as functional integration. The same processor with a universal keyboard that performs the full-featured data processing now does word processing, simply by typing in a command. It's software that makes the difference. Software which creates a sensible structure, which gives operators an intuitive sense of how it all works, making the user's job easier. To gain the most productivity, the basic functions most often used are located right on the keyboard. Return or no flow, insert, delete, tab, and backspace. A sixth key, command, invokes all other current and future editing functions via keyboard commands. With these most frequently used keys right under the operator's hand, 95% of the keystrokes are performed right on the home keyboard. This method also allows for easy addition of future functions without hardware modification or extensive procedural changes. Essentially, our design goal called for a product whose operation is evident, and to aid that, we made the product menu-oriented when appropriate. There's even a step-by-step menu provided to help the operator set up or shape a document. And once set, it becomes automatic until a different document shape is needed. Or if an overall general format is wanted with a modification for some part of the document, the two formats may coexist. To make it easier to manage documents which are updated with heavy content change, such as price lists on newsletters, the format of a document previously created can be borrowed and applied to the new document, all very simply. But here, as we promised, is a most impressive feature of Datapoint's word processing system, an exclusive capability we call AIM. AIM stands for Associative Index Method. With AIM, all you do to locate a document, a memo, a letter to a customer, a price list, is to know to whom it was sent, or when you sent it, or what it was about, or even just some key word, word fragment, or phrase that you recall was included somewhere in the text. Every document containing the information you asked to locate will be named on the screen quickly. In case you're not sure which of these documents you need, another command, search, we'll name them and also display all the text that includes the key words you seek. What we are about to show you is truly remarkable. Everything that you know is a function of your memory and association. AIM works with the human memory. No longer do we have to maintain our records by just titles, abstracts, or numbers.
Sales.
Is this Terry?
Yeah.
Hi, Terry, it's Tom. Say, you got the August price list?
Sure, hold on a second. Okay, what are you looking for?
The latest price on our test flashers.
All right. There are three price lists with our test flashers. Can you tell me what type you want?
One for warning applications.
Okay, let's try warning and test. Got them. There are two kinds, a universal and a backup.
How much are they?
They're both listed at $1.
Thanks a lot, Terry. See ya.
Now, we can deal with what we need rather than how it was stored. To some users, AIM will be the ultimate filing cabinet. Whether the word processing software is used on large or small systems, the files are compatible across all types of storage media, such as diskettes and cartridge disks, so a user doesn't have to worry about what systems are compatible with which. A user may elect to use our new letter quality printer or keep his currently installed data processing printer. Either one may be used for either purpose. The next step is to offer companies the means of directing and moving the information more efficiently to the people who need it. In other words, an electronic message system. The benefits of effective word and data processing are largely lost if you can't get that information into the hands of those who need it in a timely, secure, and cost-effective manner. An electronic message system has to help your company do its business better, to get messages to your regional offices faster, or provide better service. We considered all these factors when we designed our electronic message system. The system has to be totally dependable, not only to perform reliably, but also to prioritize messages and deliver them within specified time periods. It has to have integrity, certainty of control, and it has to have flexibility to be adaptable to a company's business needs. Datapoint's electronic message system provides many user-oriented features. For example, the four user-controlled transmission priorities. Overnight, regular assures same-day delivery. Urgent, sent before any regular messages. Immediate, for crisis situations, and sent the moment it enters the system. Every company has confidential correspondence. To ensure security, The electronic message system provides for encryption, which the sender orders by utilizing a unique code. After encryption, messages can be unscrambled only when the same code is activated on the receiving end. If the originator requests, guaranteed delivery will provide him with the exact time a message was delivered. If the originator wants to know when the recipient read the message, the system will demand the reader return a short note of acknowledgement before reviewing the message. You, the user, are in charge. You set the delivery priorities. You decide when voice versus data versus messages are to be transmitted. You decide when to use special options like encryption. You set up the way the system operates based on the particular needs of your company. Another advantage of the system is easy cost control. With EMS, a company can bill back all message costs to the originating terminals or departments. You, the user, can know the true cost of messages and which parts of your company are incurring these costs. The most unique feature of Datapoint's electronic message system is how InfoSwitch LDCS can be used to bring down the cost of message transmission to field offices or remote locations. LDCS, the long distance control system, interleaves both message and normal voice traffic going out on Watts lines or other flat rate facilities. It will transmit messages between voice calls on these lines during working hours, as well as during non-peak hours of the evening and overnight. This means that these messages get essentially a free ride, since virtually every company is paying for unused capacity on these flat rate lines. And while we're talking about efficient and economical methods of transmitting messages, consider Datapoint's LightLink. LightLink transmits messages and data across short distances, like an office park, by using infrared light. LightLink involves little equipment, uses about as much power as a common flashlight, needs no regulatory approval. But back to the electronic message system. EMS was designed to be easy to learn and easy to use. Let's just run through a brief example of how typical office people would use the system. Suppose there's a change in the price schedule. Your secretary calls up the price schedule information from data processing files and, using word processing, generates a message. Now, using EMS, she enters the options she has chosen. She requests delivery verification and acknowledgement of receipt, and because her price schedules are really important, she selects immediate priority. She enters the full or partial names of the recipients, and the system will supply complete names and mail stops. This is aim at work in EMS. Because all names and addresses are contained within the system, and this information is accessed through AIM, the system has greater integrity. It's very difficult to make an address error. When she completes the rest of the information, the full address format appears on the screen. She notifies the system that she has an immediate message, and the EMS picks up the message. EMS transmits the message immediately to all recipients. As the recipients read the message, she receives notes of acknowledgement. From time to time, the secretary or an executive can consult the video screen to see what messages are in the inbox and outbox, or review a summary of the incoming mail. This summary shows document number, priority, allows you to flag items, and states length, sender's name, and subject. From this, you can select individual messages. Even this brief example illustrates the degree of integration and control achieved by the electronic message system. Typically, a single processor can retrieve data which can be included in text or be put in message form and transmitted through different channels to various sites around the company and the country. The strength of Datapoint's approach is that it provides users with the flexibility to make choices that make the most sense for their companies. With Datapoint's products, you can grow as your need grows, in a modular fashion, with no economic penalties. You can start with any size you want, from small, low-cost field machines to large home office systems. You can start with any applications you want, data processing, word processing, electronic message system, or any combination, all using one common database. This demonstrates once more that Datapoint will continue to offer compatible products that build on the systems our customers already have. Datapoint, integrated systems yielding greater profits for their users.